إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله، أرسله الله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. إخواني في الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل. عباد الله، على المؤمن أن يستعد ليوم القيامة، ذلك يوم عسير، على الكافرين غير يسير. وإذا تمت المحاسبة، وإذا تمت محاسبة العباد على أعمالهم، أعطى كل عبد كتابه المشتمل على أعماله كلها. فأما المؤمن فيعطاه بيمينه تكرمة له، وهو الناجر المسرور يوم القيامة. قال تعالى: فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه فسوف يحاسب حسابا يسيرا وينقلب إلى أهله مسرورا. وأما الكافر والمنافق وأهل الضلال فيعطون كتبهم بشمالهم ومن وراء ظهورهم. قال تعالى: وأما من أوتي كتابه وراء ظهره فسوف يدعو ثبورا. وقال تعالى: وأما من أوتي كتابه بشماله فيقول: يا ليتني لم أوت كتابيه ولم يدر ما حسابيه. عباد الله، فإذا أعطي العباد كتبهم قيل لهم: اقرأ كتابك، كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا، وبعد ذلك يوضع الميزان، والميزان لوزن الأعمال العباد. قال الإمام القرطبي رحمه الله: فإذا انقضى الحساب كان بعده وزن الأعمال، لأن الوزن للجزاء، فينبغي أن يكون بعد المحاسبة، فإن المحاسبة لتقدير الأعمال، والوزن لإظهار مقاديرها ليكون الجزاء بحسبها. وقد دلت النصوص الشرعية على أن الميزان ميزان حقيقي له كفتان توزن به الأعمال العباد، وهو ميزان عظيم لا يقدر قدره إلا الله تعالى وقد اختلف أهل العلم هل هو ميزان واحد توزن به أعمال العباد، أم أن الموازين متعددة ولكل شخص ميزان خاص. فمن قال بالتعدد استدلوا بأن الميزان قد ورد في بعض الآيات الكريمة بصيغة الجمع، مثل قوله تعالى: ونضع الموازين القسط ليوم القيامة فلا تظلم نفس شيئا وإن كان مثقال حبة من خردل أتينا بها وكفى بنا حاسبين. ومن قال بأنه واحد استدل بحديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي صححه الألباني في سلسلة الصحيحة، قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: يوضع الميزان يوم القيامة فلو وزن فيه السماوات والأرض لوسعت. فتقول الملائكة يوم القيامة: يا رب لمن يزن هذا؟ فيقول جل وعلا: لمن شئت من خلقي. عباد الله، وحملوا الآية التي ورد فيها الموازين فيها الميزان بصيغة الجمع على التعدد الموزونات من الأعمال والأقوال والصحف والأشخاص. نعم، ستوزن أقوالك والأعمال والأقوال والصحف يوم القيامة. قالوا إنه جمع الأشياء التي توزن فيه في الآية. ومما يدل على أن الأقوال يوزن يوم القيامة ما أخرجه البخاري في صحيحه عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان، ثقيلتان في الميزان، حبيبتان إلى الرحمن: سبحان الله وبحمده، سبحان الله العظيم. ومما يدل على وزن الأفعال ما صح عن أبي درداء رضي الله عنه في حديث الذي أخرجه الترمذي في سننه قال: سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول: ما من شيء يوضع في الميزان أثقل من حسن الخلق، وإن صاحب حسن الخلق ليبلغ به درجة صاحب الصلاة والصوم. ومما يدل على وزن صحائف الأعمال حديث البطاقة المشهورة عن عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: إن الله سيخلص رجلا من أمتي على رؤوس الخلائق يوم القيامة، فينشر عليه 99 سجلا، كل سجل مثل مد البصر، ثم يقول الله لعبده: أتنكر من هذا شيئا؟ أظلمك كتبتي الحافظون؟ فيقول العبد: لا يا رب. فيقول الله: أفلك عذر؟ فيقول: لا يا رب. فيقول: بلى، إن لك عندنا حسنة، فإنه لا ظلم عليك اليوم. فتخرج بطاقة فيها: أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. فيقول: احضر وزنك. فيقول العبد: يا رب، ما هذه البطاقة مع هذه السجلات؟ فقال: إنك لا تظلم. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: فتوضع السجلات في كفة والبطاقة في كفة، فطاشت السجلات وثقلت البطاقة، فلا يثقل مع اسم الله شيئا. حديث أخرجه الترمذي. ومما يدل على وزن الأشخاص عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: إنه ليأتي الرجل العظيم السمين يوم القيامة لا يزن عند الله جناح بعوضة. وقال: اقرأوا من شئتم، فلا تقيم لهم يوم القيامة وزنا، فلا نقيم لهم يوم القيامة وزنا. رواه البخاري. وكذلك مما يدل على وزن الأشخاص ما ثبت عن ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه قال: ما ثبت في حديث الذي أخرجه الطحاوي وصححه الألباني قال أن ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه كان يجتني سواكا من الأراك، وكان دقيق الساقين، فجعلت الريح تكفأه، فضحك القوم منه. فسأل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: مما تضحكون؟ قالوا: يا نبي الله، من دقة ساقيه. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم: والذي نفسي بيده لهما أثقل في الميزان من أحد. نسأل الله تعالى يثقل موازيننا. أقول ما تسمعون، وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وهو البر الكريم. الحمد لله وكفى، وصلى الله على نبيه المصطفى. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we send blessings and salutation upon His Messenger Muhammad ibn Abdullah salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi. My beloved brothers and sisters, on the day of judgment, when people have been brought forth to account for their deeds, each person will be given their records and whatever that contains and whatever deed that they have done. The believer will be given his book in his right hand, but the disbelievers and the hypocrites and the followers of misguidance will be given their books on their left hands. And after being given their books and their records, then they'll be told to come and stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where their deeds will be weighed on a scale and a balance that is going to be put there. Al-Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah talks about this and he says, when the reckoning is completed, then people's deeds will be weighed, and on that day, nothing will be left out. The scholars have a difference of opinion on the type of scale that is going to be brought forth on the Day of Judgment. Is it going to be one or is it going to be several? The text in the Quran and Sunnah indicates that the balance and the scale is a real balance with two pans and two sides, in which people's deeds will be weighed, and the scale is so big and it can be able to carry a lot of things, to the extent that Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam says the balance and the scale will be set upon on the Day of Resurrections. And if the heavens and the earth were to be weighed on it, it will be sufficient to carry them. Do understand that on the Day of Judgment, the last stage whereby you will know if you're going to Jannah or if you're going to Nar, after the reckoning and the Hisab, is on the scale. If your scale of good deeds becomes heavy, then know that you have succeeded, because that is the final stage of the Day of Judgment. After that, then it will be decided according to your deeds and according to the scale of your good deeds, if they're going to be heavy or if they're going to be light. If your scale of good deeds are going to be heavy on the Day of Judgment, then know that you're going to enter Jannah. And that is the last stage to understand where you're going to head to. After that, you're not going to talk to anyone. The angels will come and take you and lead you towards Jannah or towards Nar. That is why it is very important that you should be worried about the scale on the Day of Judgment. And to understand how serious the scale is, your words are going to be weighed, whatever you say. And your deeds are going to be weighed and your actions are going to be weighed. And the records that the angels have written are going to be weighed. And you yourself as a human being, you're going to be put on the scale and you're going to be weighed. So that it can be seen, and Allah is just, and it can be known whether you deserve to enter Jannah or whether you deserve to enter Jahannam. And a proof that your words are going to be weighed and you should be worried about what you utter and what you say is a narration that was reported, is a hadith that has been narrated by Imam al-Bukhari. And Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu talks about a hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells his ummah, that the deeds are going to be scaled on the Day of Judgment, even our words that we're going to utter, whether good or bad. He gave an example of the words of the Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said, كَلِمَتَانِ خَفِيفَتَانِ عَلَى اللِّسَانِ, two words which are light on the tongue, ثَقِيلَتَانِ فِي الْمِيزَانِ, but on the Day of Judgment they are going to weigh heavily on your scale and on your balance. حَبِيبَتَانِ إِلَى الرَّحْمَانِ, these two words are beloved to the most merciful. Subhanallah wa bihamdih, glory be to Allah. Subhanallah al-Azim, Subhanallah wa bihamdih, glory and praise be to Allah. Subhanallah al-Azim, glory be to Allah the Almighty. The scholars have said that this hadith is a proof that whatever you say, they are going to be put on the scale on the Day of Judgment. فَلَا تَقُولُ إِلَّا خَيْرًا, do not utter unless what you're going to say is something that is good. A proof that your actions are going to be weighed on the Day of Judgment and your deeds. It has been narrated by Imam al-Tirmidhi and the hadith is authentic. Abi Darda radiallahu anhu said, سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ, I had the Prophet of Allah, peace and blessings be upon him, say, مَا مِنْ شَيْءٍ أَثْقَلُ فِي الْمِيزَانِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنْ حُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ, there is nothing that will be placed on the balance or on the scale on the Day of Judgment
that is going to weigh more heavily than having a good character and good attitude. Then Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained that through your good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through your good attitude and a good character, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you reach a level of those who fast during the day and pray during the night. And he said, the one who has a good attitude and good character will attain thereby the status of the one who fasts during the day and prays a great deal during the night. Dear brothers and sisters, good character and good attitude makes a difference on the day of judgment. And what is good character? Good character is having the scholars have simply defined it having two things. First is, people are safe from your tongue and your hands. Al-Muslimu man salima al-Muslimuna min lisanihi wa yadi. A true Muslim is the one who people are protected and are safe from their tongue and their hands. So if you want to have good character, make sure you protect your tongue from hurting people. And make sure you protect your hands from hurting people, either hitting them, or touching their daughters and wives, or taking what's not yours and stealing. That is only one side of having good character. Kaful adha. And the other side is badlul ihsan, and benefiting people, and doing good towards people, and helping people out, wherever, in whatever way possible that you can. If you have these two things together, kaful adha wa badlul ihsan, then you have good character. But if you miss out on one of them, then know that you do not have good character. But if you attain these two things together, whereby you do not hurt people, at the same time you benefit people, then know that on the day of judgment, when these deeds are going to be put on the scale, know that it's going to be heavy and it will make a difference for you to enter Jannah. Dear brothers and sisters, not only will your words and your actions be weighed on the day of judgment, the good words that you've spoken and the bad words, the good deeds that you've done and the bad deeds, also the record that the angels have written are going to be put on the day of judgment. There are two angels that are dedicated to writing whatever actions that we do. Kiraman katibin, ya'lamuna ma taf'alun. These two angels are present with us, whenever we are, wherever we are. And these two angels, they record everything to the extent that they do not even forget the slightest of things. That is why on the day of judgment, when some people are being given their records, they'll be shocked on how detailed their records are. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Kahf, that you're going to read today on Jum'ah, Surah Al-Kahf. Some people will be surprised when they're being given their record. They would say, مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ لَا يُغَادِرُ صَغِيرَةً وَلَا كَبِيرَةً إِلَّا أَحْصَاهَا. What is wrong with this record? It has not left out anything small or big. Everything has been written. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has dedicated two angels to write whatever we do. رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Dear brothers and sisters, know that on the day of judgment, the records are going to be brought forth. And on one side, they're going to be put the good records that the angels have written, and on the other side is going to be put the bad records. Dear brothers and sisters, listen to this hadith. An amazing hadith that was narrated by Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As, and was reported by Imam al-Tirmidhi. It talks about a situation of someone who's going to be one of us. A person from Ummat Muhammad. It could be me, it could be you, we do not know. But Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Allah will separate a man. Abdullah ibn Amr radiallahu anhu said that Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, and he said, on the day of judgment, Allah will separate a man belonging to my ummah in the presence of all creatures, in front of everyone. Allah will bring him separately, come and stand. And he will be given his records. And the records that the angels have recorded, the sins that he has done, the records are so many. that one record, he could see the type of sins that has been written from where he's standing till at the end of his sight. And it's just not one record that has been written. It's not a book or a paper. These are records that have been written and it has been scrolled out until where his eyesight can see, the last place that he can see. Let's say you stand on top of this building today. If the last place you can see is Machakos, then that is where that record ends. And it's just not one or two or three. 99 records that have been brought forth. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, and Allah will separate a man belonging to my ummah in the presence of all creatures on the day of judgment, and will spread 99 scrolls for him, each scroll extending as far as the eye can see. Then Allah will ask his servant, Allah will say, do you object to anything that has been written here? Have my angels who have been scribing wronged you? And have they written in this record what you have not done? And then this servant of Allah will confirm and he would say, oh Allah, no, my Lord. Everything that has been written, I did it. Then Allah would ask him, do you have an excuse? Why did you have to disobey me this much? What is your excuse? Then he would say, I do not have an excuse, Ya Allah. Did someone force you to do this? No. What was your excuse? And said, I do not have an excuse. Then Allah will ask him, on the contrary, today, this is just one part of the record. And you also have good deeds. And one of the good deeds that is going to be brought forth is a paper, a slip of paper that has been written, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasul. Rasul said that Allah will tell his servant, you do have a good deed. On the contrary, you have with us a good deed and you will not be wronged on this day. A slip of paper will be brought out on which the words Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasul has been written. And Allah will tell them, bring your weight and your scrolls. But this servant has already given up. He knows that he's going to Jahannam. And the man will say, oh Allah, what is this slip of paper in comparison to these 99 scrolls that are there? And Allah will tell them, you will not be wrong. Everything is going to be brought. Any good deed you did, we'll put it there. And any bad deed is going to be put there. He had already given up. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of his mercy, he would make the scale of good deeds be heavy. And the scrolls will then be put on one side of the balance and the scale. And the slip of paper will be put on the other side. And the moment that slip of paper that has been written, Kalimatu la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh, that has been written, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh, the moment it's put on that side, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the scroll of the good bad deeds be light, whereby they would fly, and the scale of good deeds be heavy because of this kalima. And Rasulullah says the scrolls will then be put on one side of the scale, and the slip of paper will be put on the other side, and the scrolls will become light, and they will come upwards, and the slip of paper will be heavy, and nothing could compare in weight in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This hadith gives us a lot of hope. And there's nothing that will make you succeed more than tawheed and submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and following our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whereby when you say Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, you really mean it. That everyone is being worshipped, or anything that is being worshipped, they don't deserve to be worshipped. The only one who deserves to be worshipped is Allah. That is the meaning of Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. And you mean it when you say Ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. That is, you do not follow anyone except An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, not only would your words or your deeds or your scroll or your record be put on the scale on the day of judgment, you yourself will be put on the scale on the day of judgment. It has been indicated in a hadith that has been that was reported by Imam Bukhari and narrated by Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, says Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave an example of a fat man who's not a Muslim. When he'll be put on the scale on the day of judgment, he will not be able to move anything. In this hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, a huge fat man will be brought on the day of Qiyamah, and he will not weigh more before than Allah than the wing of a mosquito. He will not weigh more than a wing of a mosquito in front of Allah. With his weight and his size, he will be put on the scale and it will not make any difference. On the contrary, look at the situation of a believer who worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This hadith is an authentic hadith and talks about Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu was a sahaba who lived during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was very skinny and had very tiny legs, small legs. And the sahabas, they would always ask him, whenever someone needs to climb up on a tree, they would tell him, it's easy for you to climb because you're light. So one day when he was climbing up the tree, it was very windy. And the wind came and blew on his lower part of his clothes, and his feet could be seen and the size of his legs. They were very tiny. The Sahaba started laughing and smiling at his legs. Then Rasulullah ﷺ asked them, "Mimma tadhakun? Why are you laughing?" قالوا يا رسول الله من دقة ساقي, because of his legs that are so thin. Then Rasulullah ﷺ said, "Do not laugh at him. والذي نفسي بيده, by the one in whose hands is my soul. On the day of Qiyamah, when Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is going to be put on the scale and the balance, his legs, they will weigh more heavily in the balance than the mountain of Uhud. Why? Because these two legs, he used it to go to the masjid. These two legs, thin legs, he used them to go to jihad. These two thin legs, he used them to serve Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." Ikhwani fillah, we should prepare for the day of judgment. And you should know that there are stages on the day of judgment. And you should know that the last stage is the scale and the balance. And that is where it's going to make a difference. If you're going to Jannah or if you're going to Nar. That is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He talked about the day of Qiyamah, He also mentioned about the scale. And He also mentioned, who are those who are going to deserve Jahannam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Al-Qari'ah, Mal-Qari'ah, Wa ma adraka mal-Qari'ah, Yawma yakoonu al-Nasu kal-Farashi al-Mabthuth, Wa takoonu al-Jibalu kal-Ihni al-Manfush, Fa-amma man thakulat mawazinu, Fa-huwa fi'ishat al-Radiyah. Wa-amma man khaffat mawazinu, Fa-ummuhu hawiyah, Wa ma adraka ma hiya, On that day, a decision will be made who's to enter Jannah and who's to enter Nar, and you'll be asked, and there'll be reckoning, and there'll be questions. But the last stage, where the decision will be made and you'll be escorted either to Jannah or to Nar, is at the point of your scale. Do deeds that are going to make your scales heavy on the day of judgment. You should worry about what you say. You should worry about your actions. You should worry, because it's going to make a difference on the day of judgment, and it will determine if you'll enter Jannah or Nar. Ibadallah, inna Allah amarakum bi amrin bada bihi bi nafsi, wa thanna bi malaikati al-qudusi, wa thallatha bikum ibadallah haythu qal, inna Allah wa malaikatahum yusalluna ala al-Nabi, ya ayuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima, اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم على أبي بكر الصديق وعمر الفاروق وعثمان ذو النورين وأبي السبطين علي بن أبي طالب اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين
ودمر أعداء الدين وانصر عبادك الموحدين. اللهم يمن كتابنا ويسر حسابنا وثقل موازيننا وثبتنا عند الصراط وزحزحنا عن النار وادخلنا الجنة بالسلام يا عزيز يا غفار. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. رب ارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله الجليل الكريم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم. ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.